Tri-Cities Community TV presents coverage of Orange Shirt Day at Noons Creek Hatchery in Port Moody.
My name is Tasha Faye Evans. My lands and my waters begin in Nanaimo. Right now we know as Nanaimo. It gives me strong, warm feelings in my heart to be able to stand here with you and your hearts on this day, in these beautiful ancestral territories of the Tsleil-Waututh, the Kwikwetlem, the Squamish, the Musqueam, and all the original caregivers at the Salt Tumup. We've seen many changes over the last 150 years. Many changes. And in the history that we share here as we stand together and gather, there is a deep wound. There's a deep sorrow. There's a heavy weight of truth that we all carry. And so it brings me warm feelings that you have chosen to come here today and stand together in community. As we all take up our own courage and our own leadership to help heal that wound. Because it takes each and every one of us. And we all come with our own truths. And we all come with our own journey towards reconciliation. But really, we all share in the same needs. And that's love, and that's kindness, and that's a sacred responsibility that we have for all of our relations, no matter if you are a first salmon people here, or if you are part of the second wave of salmon people here, we all need the same thing. So today, we're gathered here today to honor the indigenous peoples of these lands, the original caregivers of these lands that up until 150 years ago here in what we now know as British Columbia, but over 500 years across this continent that, or this country that we call Canada, have experienced tragic, incorrect behavior, tragedy, trauma. And it is for this reason that we are here today to honor the voices that are in our hearts, but the voices that are in all Indigenous people's hearts that continue to help them rise each day and help their voices sing as loud as we sing, and the dances that we dance and the stories that we share. It is because our ancestors and yours too, they dreamed us into being. No matter how hard it was to rise each day, no matter how awkward it was to go to sleep at night, no matter how many hauntings that happened in the middle of the night, your ancestors and the Indigenous people's ancestors sang you into being. And so here we are today. Thank you so much for joining us. I just wanted to share one thing before I hand it over. Dave Benny is the volunteer here at the Noons Creek Hatchery. He's been here for many, many years. And today he organized this. Today it is his heart and his path towards reconciliation that he has invited you all to gather here. And I just want to raise my hands to Dave. Thank you so much. And I invite each and every one of you to do your own thing also. So I would also like to invite up to our stage. This is Martin Sparrow. I do not know how to say your name, your traditional name.
Sparrow?
A sparrow.
No, I'll tell you why I don't have an interview.
Okay. Martin Sparrow is here from Musqueam. And thank you for coming on this day.
Yeah, I was wondering what I would be talking about when I was invited here by Brandon. Brandon and I, you know, we're carvers, I smoke fish, I'm a singer. Because I had to find my way through life when I was a little boy. I was gifted. So I was always seeing things when I was a little boy and wondering what was wrong with my mom and dad. My mom and dad went to residential school, so it took me a long time to understand what I was going through. So everything that I did all the time growing up, I was adapting to everything all the time when I was a little child. Holy Thank you. So I'll get to the last song.
I want to thank you and raise my hands to you for taking the time in your day today. I think that's one of the most powerful medicines of this day, is that you can stand here today and feel welcome to say your stories. And isn't that ironic? My husband will say, that's not how you use ironic, but isn't it, here is your land. This is shared Musqueam territory right here. And it doesn't always feel comfortable for your own being to stand here. So thank you for feeling comfortable to be on your own territory again. And I hope with all of us gathering here that we all take it in our own hands and our own hearts to make this space comfortable for all of us, particularly the original caregivers of these lands. So I wanted to give this to you, offer this to you. This is the Salmon People. It was done by James Harry. And it is the centerpiece of this first house post that was standing here, and it's named Saymamet to reclaim the space, naming it after the original village that was here, the Tsewithis village. And so in the middle of the house post are two salmon swimming together. And you sang Chief Dan George's prayer song, the Kosilis anthem. And Chief Dan George always said that Kosilis people were salmon people. Salmon is our livelihood. It's how we eat. It's how we revolve our ceremonies around. And Chief Dan George also said that all of you new people here, you live here in Kosilis lands and waters, so you too are salmon people. And so what I hope that you will take that today in as a metaphor for us learning how to swim together. There's so much for us to learn to swim together, but we all need the same things. So I hope that you will take that as. I also wanted to thank you for sharing your songs. Songs are very important in our culture. Some songs tell old stories, songs that have been sung for since time immemorial. And then there's some new songs that we sing. Songs are a way to lift spirit. Songs are a way for your heart and your soul to send messages into all the other worlds, the spirit world, the animal world. So today I wanted to invite our community member, Vanessa, to come to the stage. And we're going to sing Sequetmek honor song. Last year we all gathered here and we learned the song in response to the first uncovery of the children who never went home up into Kamloops. The nation got together and they invited everyone to sing this song in honor of the children. So on this day, on this National Day for Truth and Reconciliation, may we all join together and learn this song, and then we will all sing it together.
If you sing it wrong, it's okay. It's your heart, right? So we'll sing it a couple of times just to sort of get it in us. And at any time, if you can offer it as a prayer to those children that they find peace and that their relatives find peace, just in your heart, have that feeling. That's my feeling when I sing it. So I don't know if that's the original feeling, but some version of that I think is appropriate. Yes, okay. Here we go.
Way, oh, oh, hey, oh. Way, high, oh, hey, oh.
Again.
Way, oh, oh, hey, oh. Way, high, oh, hey, oh. Way, high, 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 hey, oh. Way high, hey yo.
That was great. Let's practice that again.
Yeah. Way yo. Way yo, oh hey yo. Way high, yeah, hey yo.
Again.
Way yo, oh hey yo. Way high, yeah, hey yo. Way high, yeah, hey yo. Way high. Way high, high, yeah, hey, yo. Way high, yeah, hey, yo. Way high, yeah, hey, yo.
How you feeling? Feel like we can do it for real now? Okay, please.
Okay. So may I invite you all to stand? If you're able. Please feel your connection with your feet on the earth. And we'll take three breaths together. And when we sing, we're going to sing four rounds. Because culturally, we sing our songs four times to let the ancestors and the spirit world know that we mean business. And the four is for all of our directions, it's for the different seasons of our salmon season, it's the different cycles of life. So we will sing four times. So I'll hand it over to Vanessa and she'll lead us in our collective three breaths and send your song to wherever you wish to have those children on their way home, find their way home, and for your ancestors to know that you are singing with them and for them, for your ancestors who are in front of you, your great-great-grandchildren also.
Thank you, Tasha.
Way.
Ancestral lands and waters. It is such an honor. I didn't know you were going to be here today. Ah, it's so good. Do you feel like you would like to come to the floor and say some words?
Yeah.
Woo, that's amazing.
White Swale, ESF Oil, CM Schapalem, Ed Hall, Tunisque, Talitan Act, Quequiclum, Tumma, OCM to see it, Eaton Alton, E. Machnitin, Ami Sap, Quequilum, E. Tunisque, Quequiclum, E. Mission, E. Scallets, Tumma. Good day, how are you all? Ed Hall is my English given name, elected chief of the Quequiclum First Nation. Honored friends, relatives, and visitors, welcome to the ancestral unceded lands of the Quequiclum people and all the other Coast Salish neighboring nations. So I am from Quequiclum on my maternal side, and I am from Mission and Harrison Bay on my father's side. So I always tell people that I'm torn between two dialects, upriver and downriver, and I'm speaking to you with the endangered downriver dialect. So it's very, very good to see all of you here. I'm honored to be here in your presence. I'm glad for those who are, you know, recognizing things that have happened historically and what we can do going forward to make a difference. I'll share a little thing that I carry with me that I borrowed from another leader. It's the four R's. It's recognition, respect, restore, and repeat. This is what we do going forward. They're trying to work with reconciliation. Hi, Sepka, thank you all.
But there is a community member here who would like to share a way that we could all mobilize in to participate in planting seeds. So I invite Mary to the floor. And then we can go, unless there's something somebody else wants to say.
Hi, folks. My name is Mary Gerges. I'm a board member of the Orange Shirt Society. That was founded by Phyllis Webstad. And I came here not knowing what was going on, but I knew Tasha was up to some real good stuff. And so I just brought my son over. And I'm so, so, so grateful to see so many people here today. So many children, so many people from the community. I wanna acknowledge Chief Ed Hall and the Quequiclum. All the matriarchs and elders who have been doing so much work in sustaining and stewarding the land here and revitalizing language and culture. This is heavy work, and we as non-Indigenous people have heavy work to do too. And so that is the call to action around Orange Shirt Society. We recently unveiled one of the very first Every Child Matters crosswalks in the country out in Kitchener, Ontario. That was the result of an incredible community sort of mobilization. And as I was standing here listening to the beautiful songs and the messages that were shared, I was like, we should have that here. So here's a little seed I want to plant. I don't know where, I don't know how, but I do know that Orange Shirt Society is going to be starting a new program where they're funding seed funding to support communities who want to do this, who want to dedicate space. This is one example, a beautiful example, but who want to dedicate space around a crosswalk, an Every Child Matters crosswalk in their city, and use that as a way to keep that conversation going, to sustain our commitment to doing this work and to walking in a good way together. So I don't know, I kind of got up here on a whim, and so I'm looking to Tasha. Stay in touch, and if anyone is interested, let's start a community group and let's start mobilizing around this. I see some influencers from the city here. We're gonna need some help from our local city to get that going, but I believe we can do it, and I believe this many people showing up today shows that we can all be committed to this work, and not just on Orange Shirt Day or the National Day for Truth and Reconciliation, but every day. So thank you everyone for being here. I feel so much gratitude. Thank you.
Well, thank you. Just raising my hands to all the Indigenous people who are gathered with us here today. I hope that you can hear our songs and our prayers and let them help the weight in your heart feel a little bit lighter. I know that we walk each day with the weight in our hearts, but it's a beautiful way to have one day where the community can come and help us share that weight. That concludes our day, but I invite you to reflect on your participation in the healing of our relationship with each other and our relationship with the land, and to plant some seeds for a future of health and well-being for all of our relations.
Way high.